Hello everyone, Serdar Yegulaub here for InfoWorld at IDG. Today I'm going to demonstrate creating a simple web application using the Flask framework for Python. Flask is a very lightweight framework, so it can be used to quickly get started creating a website or an API endpoint or a number of other things in that vein. But it's not so lightweight that projects built with it can't eventually be expanded into much more ambitious apps. For the sake of this demo, I've created a simple project in a virtual environment with Flask already preloaded into it along with anything else that we might need. Flask can be installed from PyPI, the Python Package Index, so all you have to do is type pip install flask and you should have it. I have already got it installed here, so everything's already ready to go. The basics of a Flask application are not complicated. You start by importing the Flask library itself and creating an app instance. You then use the app as a decorator to create each route or URL that is provided by your application. The first route that we have here is just the root of the application. It doesn't do anything more than simply return the message, "Welcome to the index page." As you can see, the route is nothing more than a backslash. The next route function serves the URL "Hi." Note the backslash at the end of this URL, by the way, that indicates that this service is just this URL and no other parameters after it. And that just returns the message, "Who are you?" And then finally, we have the route "Hi slash username." When you have a part of the URL in braces like this, it means everything at that position in the URL is to be extracted and passed as a variable with that name to the function that controls the route. In this case, we're just passing username, which is then returned to the user in the form of a very simple HTML template, basically just a text string. Now let's launch this program and see how it behaves. To launch a Flask application, you use Python-m to launch Flask itself as a module, Flask, and then the run command. This will look in the current directory for anything labeled app.py, which is what we have our application currently named. That's what our current Flask application is going to be. As you can see, we now have Flask running. Note that we're using a development server, which only runs on the local host. So if we go to the local host, welcome to the index page, corresponding to our first route. If we go to the route "Hi," we get the "Who are you?" message. And if we go to "Hi" followed by a name, we get that variable extracted and returned to us. Another thing to keep in mind with Flask is that when you make any changes to the application, they're not reflected until you stop and restart the app itself. For instance, you'll notice that I've changed this message to have an exclamation point, but if I navigate to that URL, I don't get one. I have to kill and then restart the Flask app before those changes will go live. Now, obviously, this only covers a very small portion of what you would create with your average web application. This doesn't touch on things like cookies or validation or any of the other things that you need for a public-facing web app. The good news is that Flask already has those things either available natively or as third-party add-ons that you can roll in without too much difficulty. If you have questions about this video, please add a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to the IDG Tech Talk channel on YouTube. And for more Python tips, be sure to follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.